along the 50-mile ridge of Cheat Mound, one of West Virginia's tallest and most rugged peaks, Paul and Lucas Kinder are behind the controls of an 18,000-pound excavator. The father and son are toppling trees and rolling enormous boulders through streams in the Shavers Fork watershed, all in the name of ecological restoration. At 5 miles wide, Cheat Mountain has more land above 4,500 feet than all of the mountains in New York, Vermont, and Maine combined. It was once home to the country's largest red spruce forest south of Maine. These slow-growing conifers live only at West Virginia's highest altitudes. However, over a century ago, the logging industry arrived and began removing 90% of the state's red spruce forests. According to Kinder, the spruce harvest took a toll not only on the trees, but on the watershed too. Shavers Fork flows down the top of Cheat Mound and is the largest high-elevation river east of the Mississippi. Deforestation had profound impacts and created an environment unsuited for native brook trout. These streams are all anthropogenically impaired because of railroads and logging, and also mining, Kinder said. Back then, we artificially straightened the streams and we bound them up by railroad grades. That's led to excessively shallow and wide streams with a lack of pool habitat and also a lack of wood, which is overhead cover for brook trout. Kinder has partnered with the West Virginia DNR, whose mission includes providing exploration, conservation, protection, and enjoyment of the state's natural resources. The project calls for the restoration of 2 miles of stream per year on public and private lands in the state, and it's not an easy task. The researchers spent the summer of 2022 adding around 50 new structures to First Fork, a tributary of Shavers Fork. They used heavy machinery to strategically place large rocks, stumps, and fallen trees in and around the stream. These new features will create deep pools and riffles. The changes should eventually restore the natural, undulating curves of the stream bed. At first glance, the sites look more like construction zones than peaceful mountain brooks. When the work is complete, however, it's difficult to distinguish the man-made features from those created by nature. Some streams in the watershed are flanked by old logging roads, making access for the excavators easier. Others are not, so the team had to create new roads. When restoration is complete, these routes will remain for hiking and mountain biking access. Kinder and the researchers work hard to recreate natural features in hopes that nature will follow suit. Often it does. Along Beaver Creek, they constructed a small dam behind which a trout-friendly pool formed. Within months, beavers arrived and built a dam of their own. They hope to assist with red spruce restoration too. After the rocks have been rolled and the trees submerged, they plant delicate saplings along the trails and near the bank. Kinder says the project exposes students to many disciplines within the field of restoration, and he brings graduate students to visit the restoration sites when he can. We're definitely making better trout habitat, he said, and we're impacting recreational value. But we're also giving the students and young people an opportunity to pull from a lot of different disciplines. You can't just look at a stream from a biological perspective. There's a lot more to this system, and it's awesome to be able to contribute, to move the needle just a little bit.